please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Well, Essel Propack is one stock that we are looking at. The Q4 earnings were quite lackluster. The management says that the muted growth was due to sluggish offtake in India in the cosmetics and the pharma categories. In fact, talking to us after a really long time is Ashok Goel, the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of the company. Mr. Goel, good morning and good speaking to you after a while. The year gone by was quite muted for you. It was hardly a revenue growth of 2% and your profits actually fell. What is the outlook for FY19?
Yeah, Sonia, thank you. It's good to be with you. Revenue growth is about 5.3% if you adjust for GST, which is a different accounting treatment. And on constant currency, the revenue has grown by 7.7%.
Okay.
Which, of course, is much lower than what we had been expecting at 15%. As far as profit is concerned, you see a dip. But in fact, if you take off the extraordinary item, then the profit is at about 176 crores against 174 crores.
It's extraordinary.
Again, nothing much to rejoice.
What is the extraordinary item you're taking out, sir?
The last year we had 15 crore extraordinary income, and this year we have extraordinary loss of 5 crores.
Okay.
So that 20 crore swing is making the difference.
Okay.
EBITDA margin actually grew by 11.1%, but it did not flow into the PAT is because our Poland unit, which is tax-free, did not make much profit, and therefore the profit, the tax incidence as a percentage has gone up.
Okay, I think, what did you say your overall operating margins are for the year?
Is 19.67%.
Okay.
EBITDA margins.
Okay, and adjusted for GST, what would be the like-to-like revenue comparison? FY18 fully.
Like-to-like, as I said, yeah. If you adjust for GST, it is 5.5% revenue growth.
Okay.
And on constant currency, it is 7.7%.
Okay.
By the way,
because the currency translation impact is making a difference.
I just want to point out that the Bank Nifty is now picking up even more. And just pull out the intraday chart of ICICI Bank now. That stock up 2.5%. If you take a look at stocks like PNB, Canara Bank, intraday, big bit of buying happening right now in some of these PSU banks as well. There's, of course, this factor of global bond yield as well. We've seen that move, I think, in India. Just see the intraday chart of both PNB and Canara Bank right now. So there's a big buying happening right now. And I think, as we discussed, perhaps money moving from, private banks to some of these high beta names for now. For now, there's quite a bit of buying in some of these
and
names.
And we didn't savor the moment. We did touch 10,700.
And
now 10,696, yes. 695 on the Nifty as well. So clearly markets are in the grip of this global growth story also. Let's not forget that we are getting good earnings across the world. The US had, I still want to savor the way the anchor was saying that are these numbers for real when Microsoft numbers were being announced. And then Japan, the Bank of Japan, upgraded its GDP forecast from 1.4 to 1.6%. So there is a global growth ticking up, and that's showing. In fact, we have the guest exactly who would be able to tell us that. What are your export earnings, Mr. Goel? And what share of the revenues come from exports? And how do you see that half doing in FY19?
Well, Lata, about 64% of our revenue comes from global operations. So only 34% of our revenues are coming from India. Having said that, if I go technically to the specific questions, our exports are about 50-60 crores rupees a year
Do you expect, how is the outlook over there? Since so many destinations seem to be doing well, what kind of a growth forecast would you have?
You mean on exports
on
or
revenues?
Generally
both
on the business?
Both exports and on overall business.
Okay, see, export, what happens is that we typically export laminates, which is the intermediate products, to our own units overseas. Mm. And those exports happen from China and India. Mm. But when you consolidate that, it gets eliminated, so it doesn't get shown in that sense. Mm. But foreign currency earning, it is okay. But on growth for the whole of next year, we believe that whatever building blocks we needed to put last year has been put, and therefore we will be back on track for growth of this financial year. The GST issues are behind us. Mm. The Europe underperformance of German unit is behind us, which is in fact in the fourth quarter has already started to grow. Huh. And we are seeing good non-oral care growth coming in US and Mexico. Hmm. So overall, we believe that we will show a double-digit growth in this financial year.
Are you facing a lot of pressures in these two segments, cosmetics and in FMCG, because of the way packaging, the industry has changed? Because a lot of companies are now moving to environment-effective packaging, using glass, using paper, etc. Is that causing a threat to your business?
Well, Sonia, frankly, no, because one, that tube is one packaging format which consumes the least amount of plastics. Mm-hmm. As compared to any other. Mm-hmm. And we in any case have come up with a program which we have codenamed Liberty, where we are going to recycle our own tubes, first starting in India, and then we will launch it globally and extend it to the brands, and if they want to collect the post-consumer waste, and we will be happy to help them to recycle the whole thing.
Okay.
So we are making efforts proactively that to reduce our carbon footprint.
Okay, that's excellent to hear. Can you just tell us what is your current capacity utilization, as well whether this carbon footprint move, I mean, whether that will tell on the margins, at least initially?
Your voice cracked, Lata.
I'm just wanting to know whether you could not hear your question clearly. Okay, what is your current capacity utilization? And because of the investment you're talking to remove the carbon footprint and recycle, will your margins show an impact?
Well, first of all, on the carbon footprint, what we are doing is we have spent the R&D money ourselves, Essel Propack.
Okay.
But the major investment is being done by third party, and our objective is to make that economically viable, which we believe it will be, based on the simulations we have done already. And therefore, Essel Propack margins, in terms of, yes, what we can do is, for the brand owners, they have their own objectives of reducing carbon footprint.
Okay.
We are just coming in helping them in reducing their carbon footprint. Okay. That will help Essel Propack to gain more market share, I assume.
Okay, we'll let you go on that note. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us an outlook on the business, which is positive. By the way, the market is soaring now and Axis Bank is still your big mover, but it has Reliance Industries for company. That stock has crossed the 1,000 rupee mark. It's a fresh 52-week high for Reliance ahead of its numbers.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of high beta names are doing well, Sonia. You know, now market is in that phase of expansion after going through that contraction. A lot of high beta names now are doing well. Just pull up the intraday chart of Adani Enterprises, for example. That stock now having a big run. There's a big move in Karnataka Bank right now. Also, if you take a look at Equitas, that's making a big move. Adani really is your stock of the moment now. In fact, 5% higher now on that stock. Sorry, Latas.
Equitas, yeah. From the word go, Equitas has been racing ahead. I don't know what it is taking encouragement from, maybe AU Financiers or something.
Yeah.
But it's just raced ahead this morning. And as you point out, RBL, Karnataka Bank are all keeping Axis Bank company. But Axis is a big stock. And that at 4.3%, 4.4% higher after those numbers. clearly indicates that the market is looking ahead for growth and not behind for what had to be accounted for.
Right. Okay. Well, let's analyze the Reliance Industries numbers then. Gagan Dixit of Elara Capital joins us now to tell us what to expect this quarter. Gagan, hi, good morning. There are many elements, but I want to just start off with the petchem business. There is an expectation that petchem EBIT could improve to almost 6,500 crores this quarter versus about 5,600 crores last quarter. Is that your view as well? And what are the key numbers to watch?
Yeah, my also similar. Actually, I also expect around 60, 65 billion rupees of the petchem EBIT that they generate. It's primarily driven by this rise in their capacity. So as compared to last year, it was around 35 billion rupees. So overall, on the Reliance earnings, whatever the growth is coming, this is primarily coming from the petchem business. So it is driving the overall things. Although their GRM would be slightly weaker as compared to last year, but this growth in the petchem, this almost more than 80% jump in the EBIT on YY basis, it will basically offset the any weakening in the other business. Right.
Okay. What is the just the bottom line? What are you expecting in terms of a profit?
My profit expectation is around 90 billion rupees on the standalone basis. I expect it's a 10% YY growth, where this overall this petchem business, as I just told, it will drive around 80% EBIT growth is coming. Other than that, this GRM, I expect some weakening over the previous year level, around $11 versus $11.5 last year, just because of weakening in the light slate cracks. But that's the signal thing actually.
And what should we be prepared for in terms of Jio?
Jio, it's in the ramp up phase actually. So we have yet to see what's the new, whatever the management gives the guidance about it. Although the last quarter's numbers were very robust as compared to expectation, but it's still very early phase to basically just, because they still need to capitalize full of the cost and other things. So then we are yet to see how this margins are emerging. But overall, in terms of customer acquisition, it is giving the surprise to us.
Do you see more upsides as far as EPS is concerned? Because, you know, for the full year FY20, the consensus view is that EPS could be at around 78 rupees or so. If they do deliver this petchem EBIT that we're talking about, as well as a surprise on Jio, do you think EPS could be scaled up higher? And what would your target price be?
Yeah, there is the many elements for the surprise that we expect. First is definitely the petchem business, and with the rise in the oil prices, we expect that there's further strengthening in the petchem margins. So that will give the booster shot, plus the stabilization of the petchem capacities, plus this refinery off-gas cracker that is also getting stabilizing. So it gives the additional margins to their business. Plus over and above, there is their organized retail business, which is itself is growing at something like 80% YY basis in the past 2-3 years.
Okay.
So this is also another surprising element that might be possible. Plus on the conso basis, because oil prices at $70 something, so this quarter at least we expect that US shale also had started adding some meaningful numbers to the over consolidated numbers. So there are 3-4 elements that definitely would generate the positive surprise in terms of earnings going forward.
All right, we'll leave it at that, Gagan. And of course, we'll be touching base with all of you after the numbers are announced. It's coming after market hours. So anytime, maybe 4:30, 5 p.m. today, you should have the Reliance numbers. With that, let's shift to other earnings that have already been announced. The Indian Energy Exchange, it's been in the news because of this day after energy prices shooting up. Their Q4 numbers were decent, not the fireworks that the energy prices have shown. The pace of growth has been a little slower than the previous year. However, the good news is that they kick-started solar renewable energy certificates trading also recently. S.N. Goel, Managing Director and CEO of IEX, joins us on the phone line. Mr. Goel, good morning. Thank you very much for joining us. It's a volume growth of 10% and a revenue growth of 8%. Are things hotting up and you should do much better in the current quarter and this current year?
Lata, let me tell you one thing, that this quarter, this year, we achieved a volume growth of 26% on year-to-year basis.
Okay.
And our profit increase was almost about 16%.
Yes.
It was 131.68 crore rupees for the year, and we achieved a profit growth of 16% this year. Mm. I mean, this fourth quarter in particular, the volume growth was slightly less because we had coal shortage in the country, as you are aware.
Yes.
And so many of the generators were not able to get coal. But as far as demand is concerned, there was a high demand in the country on the exchange platform also.
Okay. Now, is it picking up in the current quarter? I mean, after all, it's the summer, so you should have a peak.
Yeah. As far as the demand is concerned, I am seeing there is a lot of demand increase in many of the states, Gujarat, Maharashtra, West Bengal, UP, Bihar, southern states. The demand increase is there. And with the Sobhagya scheme, which is now getting implemented, the rural electrification happening, 24/7 supply. So we are seeing a lot of demand increase. Last year also on the exchange platform, our buy bids increased by almost about 20%.
Okay.
So...
okay. So, in terms of volumes then, you're sitting on a volume base of, I think, 60 billion units. What kind of growth are you expecting in FY19?
We should see a growth of almost about 20% in this year because we are going to have elections in four major states, plus this is a pre-election year. Government has also taken many initiatives for ensuring 24/7 power supply. And with the improvement in the coal supply, which has happened in the month of March and also in April, I'm sure imported coal prices are also on the downward trend now.
Yeah.
So these things should also ensure good supply. And I'm sure we should be able to achieve good growth number.
But Mr. Goel, as you per unit cost increases on the exchange, the discovered price goes to 4 rupees and 5 rupees, don't you see more merchant power, you know, short-term contracts being signed rather than depend on the day-after market, as well more PPAs getting signed? Should FY19 necessarily be more for you because there will be a natural migration to power purchase agreements, don't you think?
No. Power purchase agreements and short-term agreements are not happening because generators who have the surplus capacity, who are the merchant generators, IPPs, they are not sure about the availability of coal.
Okay.
And since they are not certain about that, they are not even in a position to sign the short-term contracts.
Okay.
Whereas in the day-ahead market, electricity market, they have to plan only for tomorrow.
Okay.
So whatever coal is available today, for that they are giving the bid for tomorrow, sale of power on tomorrow.
Okay, so even the merchant agreements are not getting signed. I definitely remember seeing Gujarat signing for about 3 or 6 months. Haryana signed for 3 to 6 months.
No, Gujarat has not signed for 3 to 6 months. They invited bids, but unfortunately
they didn't
the
sign
rate,
it.
Yeah, okay. The rate which they got were quite high.
Yeah, I know they got so, even 8 rupees, I believe. Okay, so they didn't sign.
So they are continuing on the exchange platform.
So what is the average market price now and what is the expectation for the next year?
Market clearing price these days is around 4 rupees.
Okay.
And I'm sure we are expecting a good monsoon this year.
Okay.
And if that happens, the prices should come down by middle of June.
Are you increasing the subscription fee at all?
No. Okay. No change in the fee.
All right, Mr. Goel. It was a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much for joining us and giving us a macro picture as well of the power scene to some extent. Well, that's the word on another set of earnings. But today, the cynosure of the eye is the market and the Nifty Bank is up 1%
plus. 1% plus and 270 points. First day of new series, no baggage. The market closed at high point yesterday. Overnight, good cues from the global markets. Indications were there. Today was the day when chasing the gap up would have really helped. But what from here? Sudarshan Sukhani, Prakash Kaba with us now. Sudarshan, thoughts on first hour and any interesting stocks now?
Yes, good morning again. Well, the first hour has shown us enough strength. The Nifty and the Nifty Bank are both buying opportunities. I think the trade is not for the day, the trade is for next week. You buy now and wait for next week. Your stops are 10,610. That level is also now available. So the indices are buying opportunities with a stop under 10,610 for the Nifty.
Okay. And Nifty Bank?
Oh, the Nifty Bank is 24,800. The stop. Okay. Buying is suggested in both indices.
Sure.
Okay, ICICI Bank is making a comeback after a long time. So, Prakash Gaba is also here with us. Prakash, ICICI Bank had fallen from, you know, those 380, 390 levels. It went all the way to 260. You think 260 is a bottom after looking at the move that we've seen in the last few days?
Yes, I think so, Sonia, because it's gone up, came down corrective, and correction has, I think, stopped at 278 zone. I think there's a good place to buy ICICI Bank and hold it for a slightly longer period of time. Maybe we'll see 315 zones. Of course, good 40 rupees up move is available from here. Just have a stop at 270 and trade the long side. Looks good for me, ICICI Bank.
Okay, and what about your other individual stuff, Prakash?
I like two stocks. I'll go with L&D Finance. That looks good. Good base formation here. Up move can take it to around 175 zones. Stop below 165. And I also like Shobha from the real estate pack. Here too, again, I like the structure, some corrective, more of a time-wise correction. And the move has started today. The target that I have on Shobha is around 560. Oh, it's already achieved there. I will modify the target to 570 now and have it stop below 536 or 540 and trade long on that.
Okay. Sudarshan, what I thought was a brave call in Axis has just worked so wonderfully well for you. If someone missed the bus, is it worth boarding?
It's worth holding. Axis is an investment buy. So apart from the trade that we could have done today, you can buy at current levels and hold. It's at strong support levels. There is nothing but upside left here. So I think you should hold. Be a long-term investor here.
Okay. And
this is a good price to be in.
Okay.
I have two stocks also.
Yes. Please go ahead.
Yes. One is Kotak Bank. We spoke about it. So buy Kotak Bank for the day. And the second is Sun Pharma. Sun Pharma is just breaking out today, so there's strong momentum. So both for buying.
Okay. I just want to ask you, would you shed your traditional aversion and get some trading calls in on any of the public sector banks?
No, it's not traditional aversion. The charts are saying that they are not buying opportunities.
Okay. All right.
Okay, just
I would not touch them.
Okay.
Couple of stocks. Escorts is making fresh highs. Just pull out the intraday chart of that one. And by the way, we were talking to the management of IEX. PTC is the one stock which is now surging. Just pull out the intraday chart of that stock. It's making fresh highs right now. Just pull out PTC. That one right now is at the high point of the morning. And a lot of these stocks have done well. Sandeep Wagle is also with us in our studio. Sandeep, good morning. Thoughts on PTC first, since that's the fresh breakout, and then we'll discuss your stocks as well.
Good morning, Anuj. PTC has given a breakout, and I think the move will continue. Somewhere around 95, 96 is where I would talk of PTC going to. And today's low can be a safe stop loss, which is 87. I would go with two buy calls. One is Escorts. I just heard you mention that. I see strength. Stop loss of 972, target of 1013. Call for today and tomorrow and Monday. And the second call is a buy in a ICICI Bank. I'm seeing strength. After Axis, I think that should move. Buy it with a stop loss of 280, target of 295.
Okay. Well, the market's still in a fine mood. We are not in any mood to get into corporates now because the markets are, such a sight for sore eyes. Up 1.2% on the Nifty Bank. Prakash, would you buy any of those money stocks, the non-bank finance stocks? You had L&D Finance in the morning.
Yes, I did.
Anything akin to that, say an MMFSL or any of the non-bank finance stocks?
In fact, you spoke about PSU banks.
Okay.
Well, I'll go for Karnataka Bank. That looks good, Karnataka Bank. I would say that Karnataka Bank certainly is looking good. One can see a move up to maybe around 130 zones, have a stop somewhere below 108. So that's an area that I'm looking at.
And finally, Sudarshan, Adani Enterprises, Arush pointed it out early in the morning itself. Is there a trade there?
No, the trade is in Adani Ports. We've spoken about it in the morning. That's a far better trade in Adani Ports.
Okay. A fresh intraday high now on the Bank Nifty. I tell you something, that this move on the Bank Nifty that you've seen should trigger some more short covering. 322 points higher now on the Bank Nifty, the Nifty at 10,700. We are right now looking at a big trend day. A lot of stocks surging. First day of new series and things looking really good today.